Hello everyone, welcome to the session on interquery parallelism and intraquery parallelism. These are the parallelism to query parallelism techniques which are used in the parallel database. Let us talk about the learning outcomes of this session. At the end of this session, you will be able to illustrate some concepts of interquery and intraquery parallelism, and you can differentiate between the various parallelism techniques. Now, starting with the query parallelism, what exactly query parallelism means? You can see the scenario here that a single query is there and a processor is there, and it is taking a time for 4 minutes for the complete execution. But if the same query we are giving for the parallel processors, where 4 processors are dealing with the same query, then if we are completely we are saying that the query has executed parallelly in all the processors, then the 4 minutes are divided as completely in 1 minute, that is divided by 4. So a same query can be executed in a single minute here. That is what a query parallelism is. So in parallel database system, usually the query parallelism is used to improve the performance of the system, and it is achieved through the query parallelism. The transaction throughput is increased by parallel execution for one queries or more than one queries here, based on the query parallelism. Now, what are the various forms of the query parallelism? You can see here that there are basically two types of queries parallelisms, that is interquery parallelism and intraquery parallelism. Again, the intraquery parallelism is divided as intra-operation and inter-operation parallelism. And in this one, the inter-operation parallelism is again divided as pipeline parallelism and independent parallelism. We are going to see all these one by one in detail now. Let us start with interquery parallelism. What is this interquery parallelism? The parallelism which is among the queries means whatever the number of queries are there in a particular transactions, all those queries are parallelized. So every query is executing on a different processor. So we can see here that different queries or transactions are executed in parallel with one or more processors. So the main aim of this interquery parallelism is what? That is to scaling up the transaction processing system. So you can see here the scenario, that is query 1 is executed on processor 1 and it is providing a result. Similarly, query 2 is executed on processor 2 and it is providing a result. And query n, which is providing giving the processor n, and that is providing the result in result n. Okay. So various queries are executed in parallel. So query 1 to n, all these are executing in parallel by these processors. That is what an interquery parallelism is. Let us talk about intraquery parallelism. Now, in intraquery parallelism, parallelism is made in a single query. You can say that within a query. Say for example, a query may be having n number of operations. So, those based on that query, the parallelism is implemented. So, we can say here that execution of a single query is in parallel on a different multiple processors. And what is the aim of this one? Speeding up the long running queries. So whatever a single query is, if it is taking more time for the execution, so it will improve by multiple processors. You can see the scenario here. A single query is there, which is now subdivided as subquery 1.1, 1.2, 1.n, and every subquery is provided given to a particular processor. So processor 1 to n, these are there. So a single query is divided as n subqueries, and those are given to n processors. So all the sub results are collected, and finally those are collected as result 1. So that is what a intraquery parallelism is. Now in intraquery parallelism, again there are two types. What are those one? That is intra-operation parallelism and inter-operation parallelism. Intraquery, as earlier I told, that a single query can be parallelized in variouses. So the two ways are intra-operation and inter-operation. In intra-operation, every individual operation in a query is parallelized. Say for example, a query is having a single operation to execute, but that single operation is parallelized here. For example, we can say that a parallel sort or parallel search means what is there? A query is having only one operation, that is sort operation, but that sort operation is now divided in various processors. So same operation are working on parallelly here. So that we can say as interoperation parallelism. So a single operation sorting is parallelized. Whereas in interoperation, various operations, different operations in a query are executed in parallel. See, you can say that a single query, if a single query is having sorting and searching both. So in that case, what happens? Sorting will be taken out at one processor and searching will be taken out at another processor. So in this one, what happens? More than one operations in a single query are parallelized. Whereas in intra-operation, only one operation that is parallelized. So simultaneous sorting and searching techniques, both we can execute here parallelly. So the operation sorting and searching, I have given the example here as sorting and searching. There may be n number of operations are there. So every operation is parallelized here on a different processor. Now, pause the video and think of this database query execution and let us see that what parallel query execution type this is providing us. You have to guess it. You can pause the video and guess what is the type of the parallel query execution here. You can see here what is the query, how it is divided, what are the techniques and all. So, the answer is it is intra-operation parallelism. In this, the single operation sorting is parallelized. Okay, the same sorting technique is parallelized here. So the single query sort is divided as now the sorting A to G, H to M, N to S and T to Z. These are parallelized here. So here we can say that a single operation, that is sort operation, is parallelized on these processors. How many processors are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So that is what we call it as an intra-operation parallelism. Now, more deep upon again the types of intra-operation, there are two types as earlier I told you. So the first type is what the type is partitioned parallelism. So parallelism due to the data being partitioned. So the degree of the parallelism is increased based on the large number of records. If a table is having more number of records in that one, what will happen? We will take more, it will take more time to search that table or to get the data from that table. So in that case, what we can do is we can parallelize the technique there. So let us see this scenario. Very good example here I have given you based on the diagram. So single query is there. That query is divided as subquery 1, subquery 2, subquery 3. And again that single subquery, you can see here that the operation 1 in that to till operation M, those are given. And again in that a single operation is having processor 1, processor 2 till processor K. So you can see here that how the parallelism is there. So the first type of parallelism is here, which is subquery. And again in subquery, various operations, again in that operation, a single operation is parallelized here. So that is what exactly intra-operation parallelism is called as. Okay, so this is what intra-operation parallelism is. A single operation is parallelized in a various ways. So here the operation we can take as sorting technique or a searching or any selection or any type of thing. So in interoperation parallelism, there are again two types, that is pipeline parallelism and independent parallelism. Let us talk about pipeline parallelism. What is pipeline? You can see pipeline means what? The data is flowing from one end to another one. Okay. So here also output record of one operation is consumed. Means what? One query is executing and that query is still executing, but this, the intermediate results of those queries, those are generated and those are consumed by another query or another operation, you can see. So here what we can say for pipeline parallelism, output record of one operation A are consumed by the second operation B without completing the first operation A. It means that the first operation is also executing, and but it is the second operation, whichever is dependent on the first one, is not waiting for the completion of that. It is till the first operation is going on, whatever the intermediate results it is generating, those are used by, consumed by another operation. So that is what a pipeline parallelism is. So it, we can see here that it is like an assembly line where multiple operations are executing in parallel. Okay, you can see in a mechanical ways multiple assembly lines are there. So at a time all the assembly lines are working. So one is working on that one, it is moving to the next one, again it is going to the next. So that is what a pipeline parallelism is doing. Whereas in independent parallelism, it is totally independent, where you can see here that multiple operations in a query that do not depend on another are executed in parallel. Means what? Those operations are not at all dependent on them. So those are totally worked on the two different processors. As those are not dependent on one another, okay? So they are working in parallel. So it is not providing high degree of the parallelism. Okay? Why? Because we cannot say that those many parallelism or that much parallelism is there when multiple operations totally are independent. So, for the pipeline parallelism, we can say that only useful for small number of processors, whereas for independent parallelism, it is not providing high degree of the parallelism. So, pipeline parallelism, you can see the scenario where as operation 1 with a different processor, operation 2 with a different processor, operation M with a different processor, but the output of operation 1 is provided to operation 2 in between. So that is what the pipeline parallelism is. Whereas in independent parallelism, you can see that no output is provided. So totally different operation, different processor, different operation, different processor, those are not dependent on each other. So every operation is individually working. That is what an independent parallelism is. So these are the various techniques of the parallelism, query parallelism techniques, intraquery, interquery and all. So these are my references. Thank you.